there are a lot of reasons you might feel a lump in your breast. Sometimes what you're feeling as a lump is actually a part of your normal breast tissue. This is especially true if that lump is coming and going at different times during the menstrual cycle. And that's because the breast is very sensitive to hormonal changes that we see in the menstrual cycle. There are a lot of different types of breast lumps, and many of them are benign or non-cancer. One of the most common types of benign or non-cancer breast lumps is a breast cyst. This is an envelope of fluid that has no chance of turning into a breast cancer. Another common breast lump is a fibroadenoma. These are solid lesions, but again, have no chance of turning into a breast cancer and are very common, especially in younger women. Another non-cancer or benign cause of a breast lump is fat necrosis. This can occur to the breast after you've had trauma. For example, if you've been in a car accident and the seatbelt hit your breast. Fat necrosis also has no chance of turning into a breast cancer. We always hope that when you feel a breast lump, it's not breast cancer, but there's always a chance. Breast cancers don't change at different times of the menstrual cycle and never get smaller. If you find a lump, it's important to let your primary care doctor know. Your primary care doctor will probably do a breast exam and then refer you to get breast imaging performed. When you come in for breast imaging, we'll usually do a diagnostic mammogram and ultrasound. If you're under 30 years old, we'll probably start with just an ultrasound exam. All breast imaging performed at Johns Hopkins is done by a subspecialized breast radiologist who only performs breast imaging. At the end of your diagnostic appointment, you'll get your results. A mammogram uses low-dose x-rays to image the breast. The breast is compressed between two plates to allow us to best see the breast tissue. A 3D mammogram allows us to image the breast in thin slices, which allows us to even better differentiate your normal breast tissue from a breast cancer. A mammogram uses different features than an ultrasound in order to visualize the breast. Breast ultrasounds use high-frequency sound waves and convert that information into an image. The primary advantage of a breast ultrasound is the ability to differentiate a solid lesion from a cystic lesion. A breast ultrasound is usually performed following a diagnostic mammogram. Sometimes for patients under 30, we start with the ultrasound. At the end of your diagnostic mammogram and ultrasound appointment, you'll get one of three recommendations. Hopefully, we'll be able to tell you with certainty that the lump is benign. We'll tell you this if the lump represents normal breast tissue or a simple cyst. If this is the case, then we'll recommend that you come back in a year for your annual screening exam. We also always recommend that you follow up with your doctor. Any finding that we believe has over a 2% chance of being a breast cancer, we recommend for a biopsy. That's because as breast imagers, we know that breast cancer is very common and also very treatable when we find it early. The breast biopsies are performed at one of our outpatient sites. They're very safe and they're well tolerated. They're performed by one of our subspecialized breast radiologists. These breast biopsies use image guidance, either with ultrasound or mammogram, to take small samples of the suspicious area. We use local anesthesia so you can drive yourself back and forth to your appointment. They leave little or no scarring. We ask that you don't shower the day of the biopsy or lift anything heavy, but otherwise you can resume normal activities right away. The third possible recommendation is a 6-month follow-up. We give this recommendation when we believe a finding is almost certainly benign, but we don't want to let you go a whole year before being imaged again. We'll do a 6-month follow-up appointment to make sure that that finding isn't changing at all. I hope that this discussion helped to clarify what you should do if you feel a lump in your breast and some of the reasons that a lump can form. Also, if you're over the age of 40, I recommend that you get scheduled for a screening mammogram as soon as you can, because we know that screening mammography is the best form of early detection.